Snapseed's developers define double exposure as being inspired from film and digital image processing, according to their official description. But there is more to it. We'll try for a detailed explanation here in this video. Other than the default, there are 5 more modes in the double exposure tool: lighten, darken, add, subtract, and overlay. In Snapseed, opening an image with a simple example of a white and black image. Going to the double exposure menu, I'm going to add an inverted image of the same with black on the left and white on the right. Increasing the opacity to 100 blocks the base image completely. Defaulting back to 50% where blend modes gives the best results. Tapping on the options button to get the 5 blend modes. Choosing the lighten mode option. Here the double exposure tool takes only the brighter pixels from both the base and the top images, in this case the white areas. So the result turns completely to white in this example. Darken mode works in a similar way, taking only the darker areas, in this case the black color. The result is a black image. For the remaining modes, it is better understandable with images having more colors. Opening an image here with different colors. Adding another image using double exposure with more colors. The result of this combination in lighten mode is these bright faded colors. We'll go a bit technical now on how we got this. Later I will try explaining in non-technical terms with some examples. Here I will take the first and third colors from the base and top image and see how we got the resulted bright faded colors. Every color has RGB values. For example, here are the values for the first color. There are color picker apps on mobiles too if you wanna try. Now I'll put the values of each color below. Now we'll take the higher value from these two numbers and paste it here. So this is how we get the final resultant colors for lighten mode. Because of the higher values, the colors also get brighter. The results for the darken mode are a bit similar. Instead of higher values, the results are derived from the lower RGB values. Final output being darker colors. Now to the add mode. Basically, as the name suggests, just need to add both the values, resultant being a very bright color. Note that the final value should not exceed the maximum RGB value of 255. Next to the subtract mode. Here we need to subtract the top image pixels with the corresponding base image pixels. The values are 0 if numbers go to negative. Overlay mode is the final option. Basically, the result is a more contrasty version with vibrant colors of the two corresponding pixels from top and the base image. It sort of combines the multiply and screen modes of Photoshop. Now we'll try some examples. As an example, have taken this color portrait image with a white background. Could get some unpredictable colors with the double exposure modes. Adding a nice vibrant landscape here. As we know by now, choosing the lighten option should remove the portion of the landscape on the white background, as white is the brightest portion here. Darken is basically inverted when compared to the lighten mode. Add mode adds a lot of brightness from both the images. Subtract should make all the darker parts more dark. Overlay certainly gives the best looking one here with nice contrast and colors. Now we are gonna remove all the colors by turning this portrait image to black and white. Should get more predictable colors here. Again, using the same landscape image for double exposure. Here there are no more confusing colors from the base image. Using the overlay blend mode and placing the water body of the landscape at a desired place. I'm gonna add one more darker landscape image but with a bright sky. choosing Lighten mode. Going back to the previous filter and removing the mask on the hair. Coming back, masking out the bottom part. Getting some interesting results here. Next, for a landscape edit. Opening the same vibrant image from the previous edit. Also adding this already edited sunset image with the double exposure tool. We'll try getting the warm evening colors on the mountains. Masking out the remaining portions. Using curves to darken the image and masking on the foreground to get it darker. Another example of a random abstract looking edit here. It's up to you on how creative you can be. Hope you found this video useful. Thanks for watching.